So mathematics was something that I could rely on for the truth. I could see when I could prove a theorem is always true. So it doesn't depend on what your teachers say, what your parents say, what the books say. It's always true, and I could find the freedom, I could find my passion and independence in mathematics. Well, I'm Dilaram Kahrabai. I'm an Iranian-American mathematician and computer scientist currently living in New York. And in the past few months, I've been co-chair of the trimester of post-quantum algebraic cryptography in Institut Henri Poincaré IHP in Paris. I left Iran 26 years ago. I haven't been back for about two decades almost because I don't feel safe there. When I grew up in Iran when I was a little girl, it was beginning of revolution, and when I was going to school, the teachers and the books would say something about the politics or history, which was different what my parents or at home I would hear. So I was kind of confused about what's the actual truth in politics, who came first, who killed what, and I couldn't find the truth, I couldn't find stability, I couldn't find freedom and independence in these fields. I had an aunt who was a physics teacher, and she made me curious and motivated about learning about science and made me curious about those. At the same time, I went to university with the first woman Fields medalist, Maryam Mirzakhani, who was an absolute inspiration in mathematics for me. The way women think is different than the way men think, and we need different angles when we tackle a problem. I work in cryptography because it's, well, first of all, it's interesting because I feel my work has an impact in protecting citizens of the world to protect their information. So cryptography has many different aspects and many different schemes. For example, digital signatures is one of them. One of them is so-called fully homomorphic encryption, in which, in simple word, it's you can do data analysis over encrypted big data, digital information, and all the information that we have are on internet or our bank information, or even when we go to doctor, we have our healthcare information, and these data are private. We don't want someone else has access to this. So cryptographic schemes, cryptography is a science that protects this information. Each point, this could be in superposition between 0 and 1. The crypto systems that we are currently using are based on some problems in mathematics that are not so-called quantum safe. For example, if you multiply two large numbers, it's very fast, it's very easy algorithmically. But if you have a large number, if you want to break it to its factor, it takes a really long time. So some years ago, an MIT professor, Peter Shor, in around 94, he came up with a quantum algorithm that polynomially, very rapidly, can break this large number to its prime factor. At the same time, it's not just the mathematics that should be correct. It also, you want something meaningful. You want something that works. You want something to be secure against classical attacks about artificial intelligence algorithm, about quantum algorithms. There are so many aspects, and when they come together, I really enjoy to see something that is working and it has a big impact in the society. Mm-hmm.